In this problem, we're going to look at how to come up with the rate of a reverse reaction when the rate of a forward reaction that is non-elementary is specified. And so here we have a situation where by operating at low temperature, we measured just the forward rate of reaction, so we kept conversion very low, and it's as is shown on the screen here. We see that this is not an elementary rate law because it depends on the pressure of A to the first power, but the pressure of B to the half power. The reaction orders do not follow the molecularity, and so therefore we know that this is not an elementary reaction. And so how do we go about actually trying to postulate a reverse reaction rate expression that's thermodynamically consistent? In this case, we can realize that at equilibrium, we need to have the pressure-based equilibrium constant, since we're working in pressure, here equal to the pressure of component C times the pressure of component D, so the pressure of the products over the pressure of the reactants, each raised to their stoichiometric coefficient, and so we have the pressure of B squared in this term. Furthermore, just realize that at equilibrium, the magnitude of the rate of the forward process is equal to the magnitude of the rate of the reverse process, right? So that the net reaction rate is equal to zero. Now, we already have an expression for the rate of the forward process, and that's equal to K times PA times PB to the 1/2 power. Okay, and now we just have to realize that at equilibrium, we can substitute in from this expression, and that might be useful to us. And so what I'll do is I'll solve for PA here, and we see that PA is just equal to this collection of terms. Okay, and I can substitute this in for PA in this expression. Okay, and so if I do that, then I get the following. The magnitude of our reverse is just equal to this expression. Right, and so we see that this has to be true at equilibrium. Right, and so now we can write the overall rate expression, which is equal to the rate of the forward process minus the rate of the reverse process. And if we collect these terms together, we end up with this expression as follows. All right, so that the reaction rate is equal to, again, the forward reaction rate, which is the K times the PA PB to the 1/2, and then minus this reverse rate, which is of a form that ensures that at equilibrium, the forward reaction rate here is equal to the reverse reaction rate. It depends on the partial pressures of C and D, but we also have this dependence on the partial pressure of one of the reactants, B, in order to make our expression thermodynamically consistent so that the reaction rate will be zero at equilibrium.